Hello everyone, now we have to discuss the basic quantities in circuit analysis. So what are the basic quantities in circuit analysis? Those are current, voltage, potential difference and work done. Finally, power. So these are the basic quantities in any circuit. So briefly we have to discuss these quantities, okay. First one is current. So what is current? That is the rate of flow of charge through a particular conductor. So the rate of flow of charge through a particular conductor, that is I is equals to rate of change of charge through a particular conductor. Simply this is nothing but current. Means for example, if we consider a conductor, consider a conductor, so these are the electrons movement. These are the electrons movement. So this is the particular cross sectional area in the conductor. This is the particular cross sectional area. Okay, the current which is crossing a particular cross sectional area in the conductor is nothing but, or not current, charge. The charge which is crossing a particular cross sectional area in the conductor is nothing but current. So means because of the, for example, so we have to connect this conductor across a battery. So this is for example negative terminal, this is positive terminal. So because of this negative terminal, the electrons which are moving away from this negative terminal. Why? Because electrons are having negative charge. That's why the current direction, sorry, the electrons direction is from this side to this side. So obviously the current direction is this side. This is the current direction. Means what? The rate of flow of charge through a particular conductor is nothing but current. Okay. Here the charge which is crossing a particular cross sectional area per unit time, per unit term, that is 1 ampere current. Okay. So this is about the basic current definition. And then how many types of currents we have, how many types of current we have, types of current, types of current. It is varies with respect to time. So that is I, the type is nothing but DC. So first type is DC, the current is in the form of DC, that is first type. So second type, current, and which is nothing but, which is nothing but AC, that is sinusoidal, that is sinusoidal. First type is DC response and second is AC type, and third one is respect to T, that is I, which is nothing but exponentially decaying, or we can get or you can get like this exponentially rising function, exponentially rising, or it may be like this, okay, it may be like this, or it may be like this, exponentially decaying, exponentially rising, okay. So like this, okay. Next type is fourth one. This is what? Damped sinusoidal. Damped sinusoidal. We will discuss what is damped sinusoidal later. So these are the basic types of currents. The current may be in the form of DC, or in the form of AC, or in the form of exponentially decaying, or exponentially rising. And another type is damped oscillations. So most important point, the type of current depends on the network, and the source, which is totally depends upon the network that we have selected and the source of that particular network. Depends on the network and the source of that particular network. This is very important. These total types are totally depends upon what? Type of the network and the source that we have selected. Okay. Next, we have to discuss an important observation, that is very important observation. Okay. For example, I have this circuit. So this is the value of resistor. We don't know the value of resistor, okay? And the current through this is, for example, or you can assume this direction. The current may be 10 amps, okay? Say the value of current may be 10 amps. So the current is from left to right, so downwards. Maybe the current through this branch, that is 10 amps. If the current is out of that branch, that is the indication of the current is nothing but from bottom to top. Here, top to bottom, that is we can assume it as positive current. If the direction changes, the current is minus 10 amps. So we have positive current direction as well as negative current direction. It is totally depends upon the circuit, and it is totally depends upon the current direction that we have assumed. Okay. So the important observation is the current direction, may be positive or negative. We will discuss in detail how we are getting the negative current direction, sir. How we are getting the positive current direction, sir. It is totally depends upon the assumption that we have to made in the circuit. So the current direction may be positive or negative, but for convention we have to assume positive current direction in any circuit. That's it. This is very important observation. we will discuss in detail while discussing the concept of KCL. Okay. Next, we have to discuss voltage and power. Voltage. What is voltage? Voltage is a measure of work which is required to move a charge. Means it is a measure of work is required to move a charge, So simply V is equals to dW by dq, right? Simply voltage is nothing but dW by dq, that is the amount of work done is required to move a charge from one point to another point. Then based upon this formula, what is the definition for 1 volt? What is the definition for 1 volt? That is 1 volt is nothing but 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb. 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb, that is 1 joule of work is done to move a charge of 1 coulomb. This is about 1 volt. This is about voltage. Like this, what is power? What is power? It is nothing but rate of energy. What is energy? Which is nothing but work done, right? Rate of work done is nothing but power. That is, rate of energy is nothing but power. So P is equals to rate of energy dW by dt. So we all know that P is equals to V into I, which is equals to dW by dt. So what is the value of V? dW by dq. dW by dq. What is current? dq by dt. Finally, dW by dt, right? So for example, voltage is equals to 10 joules per coulomb and current is equals to 2 coulomb per second. Current is 2 coulomb per second. Then power is equals to what? V into I, which is equals to 10 into V into I, 2, which is equals to 20 joule per coulomb into coulomb per second. So coulomb coulomb cancel, finally joules per second or watts. Finally, we have 20 joules per second or 20 watts of power is getting. So this is about voltage and power. Next, we have to discuss work done. That is, work done by a battery. Simply, work done per charge, which is equals to what? Potential difference, right? Which is nothing but potential difference, which is nothing but amount of work is done to move a charge, is nothing but voltage. Therefore, work done is nothing but energy. Energy supplied by a battery which is equals to work done by a battery, right? Which is equals to what?
Charge into potential difference.
Charge into potential difference, which is equals to charge into voltage, which is equals to charge supplied into EMF.
Which is equals to charge supplied into potential difference, charge into voltage, charge into EMF. Then you have a doubt. So we have potential difference, voltage, EMF. Sir, what is the difference between voltage, EMF and potential difference?
Voltage is nothing but voltage, which is nothing but potential difference only. Okay, potential difference.
Then what is EMF, sir?
Simply EMF is nothing but, which is nothing but internal voltage of a battery, without any current in it, without any current in it, that is zero current, that is zero current in the battery. It is zero current in the battery.
So what is EMF? Which is nothing but internal voltage of a battery without any current, then only it could be called as EMF. So for example, if we consider this battery, so what is the internal voltage here? He mentioned some voltage, that is internal voltage of this battery, that is EMF. Okay, so but what about the current in this battery? There is no current in this battery because there is no connection between this battery and the conductor. There is no connection between this battery and the conductor. When we have the current, for example, this is the conductor, so this is the battery. So when we have the connection, then only there is a current. So the negative terminal is like this and the positive terminal is like this. Then only because of this potential difference between these two terminals, we have the current through this circuit. We have the current through this circuit. Whenever there is a connection between battery and the conductor due to potential difference between these two terminals. So what are the two terminals? Positive terminal and negative terminal. Because of the two terminals, means because of the potential difference, there is a current through this conductor. Now we have to discuss why potential difference is responsible for the flow of current. As we discussed earlier, whenever there is a connection between battery and a conductor, because of the potential difference between these two terminals, there is a current in the conductor. Here I am considering one example to explain why the potential difference is responsible for the flow of current. So one fine day, Bunty went to a park with his father. So in that park, he observed that two slip patterns are there. This is one slip pattern and this is another slip pattern. So which is unused in the park, which is used in the park. Okay, first he is trying to slip by using this pattern. He is trying to slip from this position to this position, but he is unable to slip from this position to this position. Why he is unable to slip? Because the height difference between these two points is same, because this pattern should be available on the surface, on the flat surface. That's why it is called as unused in the park. But in this pattern, by using this pattern, he is unable to slip easily. So he is very disappointed. Finally, he went out from this pattern, and after reaching this position, he is trying to slip. After reaching this position, he is trying to slip from this position to this position. Now he is able to slip easily. So because of this height, he can able to slip in this pattern. He is very happy. So because of this height,
he is able to sleep. So in order to get the freeness of the pattern to sleep, we have to increase the height of the one side than the other. So this height is proportional to freeness or easiness to sleep. If the height is more value of more easiness to sleep. The same logic can be applicable to potential difference. If we have more potential difference, we have more value of current. If we have more value of potential difference, we have more value of current. If it is less, we have less value of current. The same logic can be applicable to this condition. Here I am considering one more example to explain why the potential difference is responsible for the flow of current. So we have two cases. In each and every case we have two vessels. So in this case one we have two vessels, in case two also we have two vessels. Okay, so in these two vessels I am providing a water or any liquid content, whether it may be water or thumbs up or Sprite or whatever it may be. Here I am providing an equal amount of water level in these vessels, and between these two vessels I am providing a pipe to flow the water from one side to another side. Okay, so this is required to pump the water from one side to another side. So in this case, can we get water flow through any one of the vessel to another? Obviously no, because these two vessels are present at the same height, or these two vessels are present on the same height. For if this is the surface, these two vessels are present on the height, or if this is the surface, these two vessels are present on the same height of that surface. Obviously there is no water flow through this pipe. Then how we can make the water flow through this pipe? Simply, we have to increase the height of the any one of the vessel, then only we can able to flow the water through this pipe. So now we have to consider the second case. So in this case, this vessel height, vessel one height, can be increased to some extent, can be increased to some extent. So because of this height difference, the water is able to flow. The water is able to flow from vessel 1 to vessel 2, from vessel 1 to vessel 2. So because of this height difference, there is a water flow through this pipe to this vessel. Okay, so because of this height difference, there is a height difference is proportional to what? Water flow. Because of this height difference, there is a water flow. If the height difference is more, we are going to get more water flow. If it is very less, you will get less water flow. The same logic can be applicable to what? Potential difference. If the potential difference is more, we will get more value of current, that is V proportional to I. So because of this height difference, we have to get more flow of water. The same logic can be applicable to the potential difference. If we have more value of potential difference, we are going to get more value of current. If it is less, we are going to get less value of current. Simply, the current which is present in the conductor is totally depends upon the potential difference between the two terminals of a battery. This is very, very important observation.